Wobblies, welcome to Wobbly Otter Outdoors. I'm Chris, and in today's video, we're talking about campfire concerns and the different types of campfire fuels. When looking at our campfire fuel sources, we're going to be considering for two purposes. One is for cooking, and the other is for warmth and enjoyment. So we think about a campfire, most of us think about a wood fire. They're warm, they have nice crackly sounds, and they're just really nice. However, sometimes when you're camping, there may be a burn ban in effect. When considering wood for a campfire, it's always best to burn wood that is from the area where you're going to burn it. The reason is wood can carry diseases as well as insects and bugs, and you don't want to spread those insects and diseases into new areas. Sometimes in national forests and other locations, you can gather firewood, which is good. You're getting local sourced wood. Or you can purchase it at gas stations, grocery stores, any number of convenience stores, and places like that. But the biggest challenge in using wood for a campfire is there may be a burn ban in effect. There may be drought conditions, other conditions, and you're not allowed to burn non-container fuels. The majority of times when we have encountered a burn ban, it is the level that we can use container fuels to cook or heat, but not use things like alcohol or wood. Be sure and check with the area that you're going to be camping in to know which ban is in effect at the time. Next up is denatured alcohol. When we use an alcohol stove, we usually choose denatured alcohol for the fuel. It's readily available at hardware stores. There are bottles available for carrying alcohol fuel that make it more portable. It takes about 2 ounces to run the little alcohol stove. Next up for a fuel source is a butane canister. The top of the butane canisters will have a very specific valve. As far as availability, the butane canisters can be found in either sporting goods stores or the sporting goods department of many department stores. Next up is a backpacker's choice. Because of its small size, it's very easily packable. These are usually mixed fuel canisters. Often they will be isobutane. Sometimes they will be a mix of isobutane, butane, and propane. Those are often marketed as a four-season fuel source. Next up is the 1-pound propane bottle, very readily available in a wide variety of places. 1-pound propane bottles can be used in some portable heaters, as well as many different cooking burners and grills. And with the appropriate adapter, you can also use the 1-pound propane bottle with a stove that runs off of this type valve. The last container fuel source that we'll discuss are the larger propane containers. This is an 11 pound, this one is a 20 pound. With the appropriate adapter hose, you can run a propane grill that is built to accommodate the 1 pound bottles to run off the larger propane bottles and their valves. The benefit of the larger canisters, of course, is you have more fuel available in one container. The downside is they're a little bit more of a challenge to carry. So you have to find the balance between capacity for what you can carry and how much fuel you need. A plus of the 20-pound propane containers is that you can often exchange these at convenience stores, hardware stores, many other places, grocery stores. While the 11-pound bottle is a little bit smaller and more convenient to carry, it will need to be manually refilled at a propane provider.
You mean like Hank Hill?
Yeah, like Hank Hill. Alcohol is a nice, clean, burning fuel. However, we've stopped carrying the alcohol with us as much, mainly because of burn ban concerns. We mainly use propane fuel now, and the containers we use most are the 11-pound propane bottle as well as the 1-pound propane bottle. The 11-pound is our source, and we get it filled up locally where we live. And then using the adapter, we refill the 1-pound bottles. That way we have the convenience of attaching the 1-pound bottle when cooking, and we have the larger propane bottle that we can use for our little camp shift fire ring, which we love. In the comments below, let us know what your go-to camp fuel is. We'll put links to a lot of the products we've shown in this video in the description below. And we want to thank you for your continued support. Because of you, our little channel is continuing to grow. Thanks for watching, Wobbly Otter. We love you and hope all your tomorrows are bright. Until next time.